Yes. Hey, run. This is fun. Run.
Stunts like this do nothing but try to, again, paint a narrative that frankly is false and try to get the public sentiment to go on their side. They don't work in the real world. They don't understand how the real world goes, and frankly, they shouldn't be doing this.
Joining me now is National Border Patrol Council President Brandon Judd. Brandon, thanks for joining me. Brandon, I have to ask you, I've been seeing these videos and pictures floating around on the internet today. It's of a custom-built seesaw. There's a few of them that have been installed at the U.S.-Mexico border near New Mexico. And, I mean, my first reaction to this is people, again, are using kids as political pawns. What do border agents think about this?
That's exactly what's happening. You've got these open border pundits that are trying to paint this picture that the border is safe and secure by installing these teeter-totters and having children. But again, what they're doing is they're painting a false picture. They're painting a false, they're trying to draw up a false narrative to try to make the American public think that the border is something other than what it was. I mean, all you have to do is go back to the Secure Fence Act of 2006. The Democrats and the Republicans, this wasn't just a partisan issue, but the Democrats and Republicans both understood that the border was, in fact, a dangerous location. It was, in fact, unsecure, and they had to put these fences up. Now you've got, again, for political purposes, you've got too many people that are trying to pull away from that and say that the border is, in fact, safe and that children can play, and that is not the truth. It is a dangerous location. Cartels control all of the border, and to show that kids can play back and forth is completely and totally ridiculous.
So I'm reading some of the articles about the professors that helped put this together, these custom-built seesaws. So there are two California professors. One of them's name is Ronald Riel. I tried reaching out to him. He didn't respond to me. And apparently they've been trying to put this together for 10 years or so, but finally, conveniently, they can do it now, during the Trump presidency. Of course, it didn't happen under Obama. But when I look at the visuals, what they're suggesting to me is that they take issue with the border fence that has probably been there for quite some time in New Mexico, suggesting to me that they are against any sort of border protection, border wall, border fence, and that they would support open borders. That's how I interpret it.
That's exactly the image that they're trying to portray. And again, what's really frustrating to myself and Border Patrol agents alike is these are individuals that sit in a classroom or sit in an office, air-conditioned office, and all they do is think. They don't actually go out and do actual real-world work, and so they don't know what the realities are. You know, the Border Patrol agents that patrol the border, 52% of which are Hispanic, will flat out tell you that the border is not secure, that it's not safe, and stunts like this do nothing but try to, again, paint a narrative that frankly is false and try to get the public sentiment to go on their side. They don't work in the real world. They don't understand how the real world goes, and frankly, they shouldn't be doing this.
So is this not illegal? The fence that's there belongs to the U.S. government, I believe. So people can just come and demonstrate and put whatever they want on U.S. property?
They can. As long as they don't permanently affix something to that fence, they can do that. I mean, it would be akin to somebody sitting on a low wall right outside of a government building. I mean, you can do that. But if they leave it there, then obviously Border Patrol agents are going to come by and pick it up. And if they try to permanently affix something to that fence, we will take it down. But if that thing was just put together and it's not permanently affixed, they can, in fact, do that.
Well, the article said that they installed it. And so the way that they look, it's not connected to the fence. It's just in between the spaces in between the fence. But do they have to take it down and take it home at the end of the day after their drone and Photoshop with all the friendly reporters that came out to do the story with them?
Yeah, after their publicity stunt, they will have to take it away. And if they don't take it away and they leave it there, then Border Patrol agents will come by and they will take it down.
Have you seen other stunts like this in the past? I remember there was some artwork not too long ago. I mean, this is something that happens regularly.
Yeah, we have artwork on a regular basis, but something like this, using children as pawns, this has never happened before. And again, that is absolutely atrocious on these individuals' part to try to use children to push across their political views, their political narrative, and their agenda. That's wrong.
Have you had a chance to talk to any other Border Patrol agents to hear what they think about this so-called art at the border?
Yeah, I've spoken with a great many agents, and again, I've gone down there and patrolled the border myself. When people try to make statements that are false statements, it undermines the work that Border Patrol agents are trying to do. We're trying to secure the border for the American public, the safety of the American public. And when they put up this artwork, when they try to create publicity stunts like this, it undermines our work. It makes our job a lot more dangerous, and it bolsters the criminal cartels. It lets them know that there's this sentiment in the United States that allows them to continue to operate. These criminal cartels use these children. They rape them. They abuse them. They recycle them to get them across the border and put them back with other adults that are not their parents. This is what's actually taking place at the border. And for these professors to not actually paint a true picture of what's going on, it does a disservice to all of these people that are being injured by these criminal organizations and these criminal cartels. Instead of trying to help us get a control on the border and have people cross the border legally, not illegally, cross the border illegally, these people are just perpetuating this cycle of violence that is taking place at the border.